Guam, A History of Struggle and Resiliency by Isaac Feliciano. Guam is a small island in the Pacific that is a United States territory and is known as where America's day begins. Guam has a rich culture which was achieved through multiple hardships throughout their history, which in turn made the island what it is today. Guam has seven main historical eras. One of the main events occurred on March 6, 1521 with Ferdinand Magellan. Conquistador Magellan was the first European to come in contact with Guam. When arriving at the island of Guam to try and take over new land, there was an altercation between a soldier and an islander. Due to this, the islanders quickly jumped into their proas and began to launch spears at the European in order to defend themselves from the invaders. After Magellan and his men, thinking that they defeated the Chamorros, to their surprise, more islanders appeared. They came in canoes armed with more spears. Once Magellan noticed he and his men were practically outnumbered, he ordered his troops to fall back and stop the fight. They came to an agreement and peace was established among them. Once peace was declared, the Europeans and the Chamorros began to trade goods. This was until one of the islanders was accused of theft. As punishment, Magellan decided to torch some of the huts on fire and leave the island. He named the island Isla Ladrones, which translates to Island of Thieves. After Magellan, more foreign sea navigators visited and settled on the island, bringing suffering to the Chamorros. Days were filled with violence and theft. There were several times where islanders were kidnapped by pirates to serve as slaves and escorts to guide them through the Pacific. This was just the beginning of Chamorros losing their land. The year was 1668, and another man arrived on the land of Chamorros, Father Diego Luis de San Vitores. He brought the religion of Christianity to the island and established the first Catholic church in the village of Agatnia. The islanders suffered a dramatic decline in their population due to diseases brought in by the Spanish. From an approximate amount of 100,000 Chamorros, it declined to around 24,000 because of diseases such as smallpox and other diseases their bodies weren't naturally immune to. Due to the lack of medical intervention to the people of Guam, many lives were lost. The Chamorros were also forced to migrate to church-centered villages. Many lives were lost during this forced migration, the orchestrated by Governor Jose Madrazo. There was another decline of about 3,000 Chamorros. The Spanish also destroyed Chamorro proas in order to prevent them from fleeing Guam. Many lives were lost, causing another decrease in population. The Spanish would force the island woman into marriage, which resulted in the mestizos race. This played a huge role in the decline of the pure Chamorro bloodline. By 1758, only recorded 1,700 Chamorros remained between Guam and Rota. The capture of Guam. On June 20th, 1898, marked a new challenge and change for the Chamorro people. This was the day when the USS Charleston arrived in Agatnia port of Guam without notice. The Spanish had no idea of the plans for arrival and take over, so they surrendered the island without a fight. The capture was led by Captain Glass, who instead of following his full orders to destroy all the Spanish forts, decided to keep them all. This is why you can see many Spanish-style buildings, which still stands today. With the arrival of the Navy, the people of Guam were introduced to a more Americanized way of life. Guam became a territory where a colonial administration was established. The people of Guam lacked self-government and the rights granted to other U.S. citizens on the mainland. Short notice change. Early morning, at just 4:45 a.m. on December 8, 1941, Governor George McMillan was informed about the attack on Pearl Harbor. Little did he know that in only 3 hours, 42 minutes, at 8:27 a.m., the Japanese would attack the small island of Guam. The Japanese bombers started in Petey and continued bombing throughout the island. The attack that day lasted 8 hours and 33 minutes. The airstrike did not subside completely yet. By 8:30 a.m. the next morning, the Japanese began their attack once again by air. Later on, more than 5,000 troops moved in, defeating the U.S. Once the Japanese took over the island, for the next 2 years, the Guamanian people were victims of torture, forced labor, and beheading among the other unimaginable actions. The Second Battle of Guam. 31 months later, after the failed first attempt to protect the island from the Japanese, the U.S. arranged a larger campaign known as Operation Forager. Their objective was to liberate all the small islands in the Pacific that were taken over by the Japanese. During the Second Battle of Guam, it was about 59,000 US forces versus only about 18,000 Japanese service members. The Second Battle of Guam officially ended on August 10, 1994, when the Japanese organized resistance retreated. But the Japanese soldiers who were hiding and continued to fight were eventually discovered on January 24, 1995. A few months following Guam's liberation, Navy Admiral Chester Nimitz established Guam as headquarters for the rest of World War II, as it was a strategic midpoint between Hawaii and the Philippines. Today, July 21st is celebrated and marked as Liberation Day, as a victory for the island and the people of Guam. The Japanese war on Guam was a horrific nightmare that traumatized the Chamorro people. Positive changes. After the devastating and massive invasion and destruction of Guam during World War II, it was time for Guam to begin rebuilding. As time passed, a larger military presence was seen on the island. Bases were established, more people inhabited the island, and huge change was being seen. The Guam Organic Act of 1950 was established in order to redesignate the island as a U.S. territory. Once again, the Chamorro people were granted U.S. citizenship. The main military bases established were Guam Naval Base, located in the south, and Anderson Air Force Base, located in the north. With the bases, Guam became a center of activity for economic and commercial development. With change, doors were opened for major tourism, where people from all over the world can come enjoy what the beautiful island of Guam has to offer. With tourism came a boost in the economy. Still today, Chamorros have preserved their rich culture that was passed on from generation to generation. It was an extremely arduous journey, but the Chamorros have proved to be proud, strong, hospitable, and resilient people who will overcome anything in the land. Where America's Day begins.